So at long last, the half-scale Cybertruck is finally done. It's one of the projects that we're most proud of here at Hacksmith Industries.
We're getting close to completing the Cybertruck. We just need to finish the windows, the painting, the tailgate, the
counter brakes,
then the lights, the interior lights. We need to add a weather stripping across the top of the hinge.
And don't forget the air struts, so the top window actually stays up so you can get in.
And then we'll be ready for the grand reveal.
The half-scale Cybertruck dashboard.
You want to actually slide it through the window?
Make sure it'll scrape.
How do you think this is going?
Not great. Turn it.
I don't entirely agree with what we're doing, but I'm not going to stop. That's approximately what it looks like.
So we just got the windows installed temporarily into the vehicle so that we can align our dashboard, make sure that it's perfectly straight. It looks good. We'll weld it into place, and then we'll see if the marble fits in. Be careful of the windows, we don't want to scratch them. So this side is going to go underneath that lip there. How does that look like on your end?
It looks pretty good.
This side sags a little bit, so when we're actually welding it, we got to make sure to hold it up. So I'm pretty happy with that. Let's put a tack on either end, and then we'll be able to take the windows back out, do the full welds, and hopefully make the mounts for these as well. All right, that's it just about perfectly. No Cybertruck would be complete without its unique folding tailgate design. So I've been here trying to make it work on our half-scale model, and I think I figured it out. Let me show you how it works. So first, we'll have a hinging lid which will open in order to access the mechanism. Then there's two supports that'll fold out that'll actually provide strength to the body of the ramp. And finally, the ramp will be able to slide out and unfold like a staircase so you can drive up it. There's a lot of moving pieces in the design, so it's important that we have an accurate model to ensure that when we build it, it can unfold properly. All right, that's the last little bit of welding done on the tailgate. So now we've got a nice working lid. So the next step is to assemble the whole thing. Let me show you how it goes together. Now that we know everything fits, let's go mount it on the vehicle.
This part of the Cybertruck build was sponsored by Raycon. I don't know about you guys, but wired earbuds suck. The cables are always getting tangled, they get caught on things, it's just not convenient. Raycon wireless earbuds are the answer. The new E25 model has 6 hours of playtime, seamless Bluetooth pairing, loads of bass, they fit great, and come in awesome fun colors. They sound just as amazing as other top audio brands you know, and they only cost half the price. I even use them when editing videos. And with several different earpiece sizes, you can ensure a perfect fit to isolate external noise. I even use them when doing metalwork. Speaking of fit, could you do this with a pair of wired earbuds? Plus, they're so comfortable, sometimes I forget I'm even wearing them. To upgrade your earbud game today, click on my link in the description below. BuyRaycon.com/Hacksmith to save 15% off your purchase of earbuds.
I'm working on brake lines.
For the
power loader? Cybertruck.
thing will feel so much more fun to drive when there's actual brakes on it.
With such a heavy truck, we have to make sure to be able to stop on a dime. We just got the mechanical brakes installed on the truck, which are not only going to be more responsive, but also more reliable than electronic braking alone. So our DigiKey order just came in, and these are some of the last parts we're gonna need to finish up the electronics in our Cybertruck. And this is what I'm really excited about. This is actually our power supply, which will be able to charge our Cybertruck from 0 to 100% in under 3 hours. And it uses 220 volts, which means we'll be able to charge it off of any EV charging station. Thank you, DigiKey, for making this very complicated electronics project very convenient. If you'd like to see the full schematic diagram of the Cybertruck, check out the maker.io link in the description below. So what I'm currently working on is setting up the CAN bus communication between the ASI motor controllers and the tablet app. So we start off over here, where you can see the signal being produced by the controller. That CAN line is being picked up by the Arduino and translated to show our voltage, motor RPM, motor current, vehicle speed, and the temperatures of the controller and the motor. Finally, it's being sent over to the app. It'll be able to display all of our information, as well as control things like our lights.
All right, so we were planning on finishing the inside of the Cybertruck using this fake leather vinyl wrap. Problem is, we found out it's kind of hard to apply on the inside of a car. Usually it's meant to go on the outside of the car. There's a lot of seams, which we didn't really like the look of, and then if we ever wanted to repair it, we'd have to make more seams. So instead, we're gonna go with truck bed liner, basically a black rubberized paint coating that's nice and durable, and I think it will give a really nice consistent finish over the entire inside of the Cybertruck. And then we can also use that for the outside edges like the fenders and the bumpers. So let's strip down the entire Cybertruck. I'll get that truck bed liner on order and then we'll be able to finish the Cybertruck.
Now that the interior and the exterior of the Cybertruck are dry, we gotta peel off all the masking tape and see what it looks like.
In the last video, you saw exactly how much torque this thing has. I mean, literally, we were making smoke in the garage just burning those tires out. But we want even more torque, so Stan's agreed to upgrade the rear motor for us so it has even more power. Let's go.
Hey, Bill.
Hey.
Good to see you.
Good to see you.
So we've got some new motors.
We do.
I'm excited.
The motor that you're going to put in for the higher torque application, what we've done is we've used multiple thin conductors in parallel. A lot of the motors, the high power motors that you see, have been wound by hand so that they're able to get the high current through.
The first motor you've run uses a hybrid magnet. We've taken a small amount of neodymium and backed it up with a ceramic magnet.
But for our new motor, it's pure neodymium.
Very thick neodymium magnets. You can have a higher flux level without demagnetizing the magnet. The higher flux level will just lead to higher torque.
Between the neodymium magnets and the more wire wraps, we're going to be able to run more power through the motor, get more torque.
The new rear motor has 130 newton meters of torque. Add that to the front motors with 720 newton meters of torque together, has 850 newton meters of torque. For comparison, an F-150 V8 5-liter engine only has 400 foot-pounds of torque at the engine, which of course means we're going to challenge it to a tug of war in the next video.
Now that we're done painting the interior and the trim of the Cybertruck, we just need the finishing touches to get this thing done. I've just finished programming an RFID module for a Tesla Cybertruck, which we use to scan the unique identifier on each one of these key tags. If it matches what's programmed into the Arduino, it trips this relay and opens our latch. It's really awesome seeing the entire electronic system work cohesively with the app. The driving mode tab allows us to control things like our ignition, driving mode, gear shifter, and even things like our door locks and tailgates. We can even open the charging port. The lighting tab gives us full control over every light bar in the entire car, including the headlights, off-road lights, interior, truck bed, taillights, and even fog lights, as well as their hue and brightness. And finally, the motor controls tab shows us all of our CAN bus information for every motor. These are the finishing touches to get the Cybertruck done.
All right, so at long last, the half-scale Cybertruck is finally done. It took a bit longer than we expected. I think when we first started out, we were expecting to finish it in like 2 weeks, which wasn't really realistic. Especially with all the design and project creep we had. We just kept thinking of all these cool attachments and bells and whistles to add to this thing, which ended up making it awesome. Like the charge port, like we can literally charge this at any EV charge station. That's freaking awesome. And all the LEDs, the iPad as the dash, even the marble dashboard. Like we didn't have to do that at all, but because we did, it's a really polished project. And I think probably one of the projects that we're most proud of here at Hacksmith Industries. Now, you guys might be wondering, how much did a project like this cost to make? Well, component-wise, there's about $10,000 worth of parts in this, not including the motors and speed controllers that we got for free from Accelerate Systems Incorporated. On the labor end of things, we've put about $40,000 worth of time into it, which means this half-scale Cybertruck cost more than a real Cybertruck. Crazy, right? But that's the cost of prototyping things. Cars are only cheap because of mass production. If I had to guess, I bet the real Cybertruck prototype cost upwards of $1 million. Anyways, we have a super awesome test planned and grand reveal video. Make sure you're subscribed with notifications turned on. You're not gonna wanna miss it.